गुड मॉर्निंग, वी आर एट बीर। एक बार सिटी पे कूद गए, आज माउंटेन और स्नोई माउंटेन पे कूद जाते हैं। चलो welcome back to my channel. Today we are on our route to Beer Billing. Let's take a break from Dharamkot and explore a new territory of Himachal. Good morning. So we are at Beer and we are at our second home for Beer, for Bunkers. We are here today for paragliding. Today morning we woke up at 7. I slept at 5 a.m. Why? This is such a chill property. So even this is a property of Bunkers.
This is the second property of Bunker after Dharamkot in Beer Billing. This is where you enter from, is the main common area at the reception, and it's a pretty fun area to chill with. I really, really regret not living at Beer because we were here for only a couple of hours and then we had to go paragliding. So this is the entrance, the main hall where everybody chills, and on the left side of the main halls are the 6-bed dorms, and there you have piles full of books from different genres, games, Jenga, sequence, and Uno, and everything that you need to spend your time and chill at the cafe, because at Bunker they have a strong culture of chilling together. And on top you have more floors. What was very, very interesting and exciting for me was to see this map from Lord of the Rings. And little did I know, to my right was a shelf full of pages from books, and you guys know I'm a book lover, so I absolutely love this. And this is the outer corner again. Bunker life is incomplete without a little bit of bonfire and of course our traditional Tibetan prayer flag. And yeah, this is just the entrance. You see Surya chilling there.
In the next 5-10 minutes, person will come to take us to go paragliding. Ek bar city pe kud gaye, aaj mountain aur snowy mountain pe kud jaate. Chalo.
Are you excited?
Yay!
To do what?
Finally, paragliding for the first time in my life. Kab se wait kar rahi thi. So finally, I'm gonna do it today.
Kud jayegi ye. We're just waiting for our divers, the people that will dive with us, to come pick us up, take us to the top and jump.
Cab ride to the paragliding site was a mess because so in the rush to reach on top that they were driving so like at speed. This is where the top of the Beer Billing paragliding is. Every point starts from this. It's a huge hill. Beer is the takeoff point and Billing is the landing point. And because it was a Sunday, there was a lot of traffic. As you can see on the other mountain, there are a lot of people. Because it was a tandem jump, that means I was jumping with a person, a paragliding expert, and he was like going to take off care of the entire system, and all I had to do is just sit and film. They spend a good 10 or 15 minutes adjusting it, and they give you all the instructions of how to do. He asked me to run. While I enjoy my flight, here are some fun facts and information about Beer Billing. Beer is considered as world's second best place for paragliding after Lake Como because it has the best place to start, which is Beer, at the landing site of Billing. In 2015, Beer hosted World's Paragliding World Cup, which is an achievement in itself. So you guys can understand ki paragliding karne mein yahan kitna maza aayega. So if you guys literally have the fear of heights and you want to overcome it, paragliding is the most safest way to do it, because all you have to do is sit in this little bag, which is a socket, and the person above you, which is the paragliding expert, they will make sure that all the equipments, everything is correct, and all you have to do is just sit in the socket and enjoy it. As you can see from top, on one side are the massive Dhaudhaar mountains with Slokhat mountains. At the bottom you see forest. One of the biggest things when I was like looking for the budget of paragliding, we spent around 2200
rupees. 2000 was for the paragliding and then 200 was for the GoPro. But this is a rate that we got exclusively from Bunker. But actually, we found out later that if you go to the main landing site and you ask the people there, you can definitely bargain for prices because people have done paragliding for as cheap as 1500 and with GoPro for as cheap as 1900. So this is something that we found out later. So you can definitely go and get the paragliding rates for the cheaper, so you can definitely bargain. I know it's ideal to jump during the sunset, but I would really suggest that if the day is cloudy, ask the people, ask the expert at the landing site. Like today, the day was going to be cloudy during the sunset because it was going to snow in the upper parts of Himachal that night. So when it snows at the upper part of Himachal, the wind becomes crazy at the lower parts as well. That's why we got the instruction of not jumping during the golden hour and not seeing the sunset. Also, if you are going at the peak of winter like we did, like January, February, don't forget to wear your gloves because on top you have to hold this GoPro. Don't forget to wear double layer of clothing and proper equipment, proper gloves and a beanie so that you are protected from the crazy winds that are up there because you have no idea the altitude that you are on. Standing, we are almost on the top of the monastery where Dalai Lama himself visits, and he stays at the monastery and does his work from there. So that was a crazy experience. And during landing, yes, I did tell my instructor that if we don't land, because literally at the bottom, as you can see, there are people, they're living there, and I was like, if we don't land on the landing, then that's okay, we can just land on some person's chat, and then unko bole ki hum land karke hame chai wai de do, hum chai wai peke chale jayenge. Which is of course not the way to land. We made sure that we landed correctly on time, and yeah, as soon as I saw the ground, I was like, oh no, ये तो खत्म हो गया. But this was the most magic experience that I could have ever imagined. If you are ever planning to go to Himachal and to go to that belt of Dharamkot, definitely go beer and do paragliding because it's an experience of a lifetime. We were then hungry, so we went to the most recommended place on the land of beer, Billing, Awas Cafe. Awas Cafe is not your typical South Indian eatery. They do, yes, serve everything South Indian, but the vibe of that place was so contemporary. The seating areas especially, and on the top where it is the terrace, it was so contemporary with the woods, and I absolutely love the area. You can sit on the terrace and see these paragliders paragliding just right above you. This is an experience, a view that you should definitely take. The next thing is we went to the Tibet Valley. These prayer flags that you see hung in the entire region of the Himalayas are used to bless the surrounding countrysides. These prayer flags come in a set of 5 colors. Each of the 5 colors responds with 5 elements of the Chinese theory. The blue symbolizes the sky, white symbolizes the air and wind, red symbolizes fire, green symbolizes water, and yellow symbolizes earth. This was a little bit of information about the prayer flags. I thought, because you guys have been seeing in all of my vlogs, I thought it's only fair to give information about what these are and how important these mean to the people of Tibet. And to the Himalayan culture. Thank you so much for watching this video. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe to this channel because I post new videos every single week. And I will see you guys in the next video. Here's a little bit of sneak peek of almost last episode of my Himachal series. I will see you guys in the next video. Till then, take care. Bye.